Good morning, children. Let's continue our science chapter, that is chapter 9, Plants Form and Functions. First video, we already discussed categories of plants, the parts of a plant, the structure and function of root and stem. Now we'll discuss about leaf. A leaf is a flattened green structure which arises from the node of a stem or its branches. Leaves of plants differ in shape, size, and even color. So, children, you also notice that some plants have big size of leaf, and some plants have narrow size of leaf, and some plants have red color leaf or yellow color leaf, green color leaf. Okay, so different shape, size and colors of leaves are there. Then parts of a leaf. A leaf consists of two main parts, petiole and the leaf blad or lamina. The first video, children, I discussed which one is petiole. Here also you can see, this is petiole, okay, this is axillary bud, and this is lamina, okay, this borderline is known as lamina. The flat green portion of the leaf is called the leaflet or lamina. It is attached to the stem by a narrow short stalk called petiole, okay, this is petiole. If you observe the lamina carefully, you will find that a network of lines is present. Here you see, lines are there. The petiole continues in the lamina as a thick vein in the middle. This vein is called the midrib. So what is midrib? See, this one is midrib. Okay, the midrib branches out as veins to form a network. The veins perform two functions, transport water and food, provide support to the leaf. The arrangement of leaves in the leaf blad is called venation. Okay, so what is venation, children, you remember? The arrangement of veins in the leaf blad is called venation. Leaf venation may be either reticulate or parallel. Here you can see, children, two types of venations are there. This is reticulate venation and this is parallel venation. Reticulate venation, veins are arranged in a net-like pattern on both sides of the midrib. This is seen in leaves of plants like pea, gram, rose and mango. In parallel venation, children, you see veins run parallel to one another. Here you see parallel lines are there. This is seen in leaves of plants like grasses, banana and palms. Children, what interesting thing you remember here, it is written in your book. If plants whose leaves show reticulate venation have tap roots, and while those with parallel venation have fibrous roots, then comes to function. Leaves make food for the plant by the process called photosynthesis. Leaves require water and carbon dioxide from air in the presence of sunlight and a green pigment present in the leaves. And that green pigment is known as chlorophyll. Food is prepared by the leaves. Oxygen is given out in this process. So here, the reaction is given, photosynthesis reaction, carbon dioxide plus H2O means water. If we combine these two things, then we get food and oxygen in the presence of sunlight and green pigment. Tiny pores called stomata are present on the leaf surface. There is an exchange of gases, carbon dioxide and oxygen, which takes place during respiration and photosynthesis. The gases produced during this process are given out through the stomata. Plants give out extra water from the leaves in the form of vapor through stomata. This process of loss of water in vapor formed through the leaves is called transpiration. And transpiration helps in keeping the leaves cool. In some cases, leaves are modified to store food, as in onion, or reduced to spines to reduce water loss, as in cactus, or modified to trap insects, as in pitcher plant. Then comes to flower. Children, you remember, a flower is the reproductive part of the plant. It helps the plant to produce more of its kind. For this reason, it is the most important part of a plant. Then comes to parts of a flower. Flowers vary in shape, size, color, but most flowers have the same basic structure. Okay. For this structure, a flower in general shows four sets of parts arranged in rings. Okay. Called holes. Four types of holes are there: calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. So these are four holes present in the flower. Calyx. What is calyx? Calyx, the outer hole. Outermost hole is known as calyx. Okay. Which is seen like small green leafy like structure called sepals. Individual part of a calyx is known as children. Sepals. Sepals protect the flower in its bud stage. Means young, unopened condition of a flower. So here figure you see, one figure is given. Children, you see, this whole part is known as calyx and this individual part means one part is known as sepal. The next hole is corolla, consists of a petals. This colorful figure you see, children, this is known as corolla. And individual part is known as petal. These are the most prominent part of a flower and are usually bright color. Large, brightly colored petals can be easily seen in flowers of China rose and Gulmohar. If we remove the sepals and petals, we can see the next hole. Already we discussed, children, petals and sepals. The next hole is, children, androecium, and it consists of stamens. These are the male reproductive parts of a flower. So which one is the male reproductive part of a flower? That is stamen. Okay. Each stamen consists of two parts. A thin long stalk called filament and knob-like structure at the tip of the filament called anther. The anther produces male gametes in large numbers. Here you can see, children, these are androecium. okay, and this individual part is known as filament. It has two parts, filament. Okay, then here you see clearly which one is anther and which one is filament. This part is known as filament and this upper part is known as anther. Okay, then fourth hole means innermost hole of a flower is gynecium, consisting of the pistils or carpels. So individual part is carpels. Okay, they are the female reproductive part of a flower. Each pistil consists of three parts, that is ovary, style and stigma. Here one figure is given, you see, ovary, style and stigma. Within ovary, ovules are present. Ovary is the swollen portion at the base of the pistil. The ovary extends above as a thin long structure called style. The style ends in a knob-like structure at the tip called stigma. Clear? What is ovary, style, stigma? The stigma receives the male gametes. The ovary contains many bed-like structures. These are called ovules. These ovules contains the female gametes. Ovary and ovules finally develop into fruits and seeds respectively. In most plants, all the four holes are present in a flower. Such flowers are called children complete flower. Okay, for example, pea, mustard, hibiscus, etc. And which flowers have not all the holes? They're known as incomplete flowers. Date palm and mulberry are incomplete flowers. Okay. So children, you understood what are four holes. Okay. So after this you should learn, okay, the important terms you learn. Then here functions are there. Main function is children reproduction, then source of food, then ornamental values. So you read this chapter carefully and properly and by heart all the terms, because these terms are very very important for your next class. Okay, thank you.